Nagle-load pa lang. Okay. Sige. So, recording has started. Forward rate is 123 yen per dollar. Spot rate is 120 yen per dollar. That's a difference of 3 more yen per dollar in the forward market. 3 divided by 120, that's 2.5%. Dahil 90 days ito, 2.5% times 360 over 90 or 365, depende sa rounding. That would give you a 10% premium. The correct answer is letter boy. A premium of 10%. Very good, everyone, for answering. Okay? Lahat ata kayo sumagot ng boy. Okay. Which of the following financial instruments is a contract that fixes a currency exchange rate at a future date? Go. Enter everyone. Enter everyone. Okay, as previously discussed in the last meeting, this is a currency future or a currency forward. If it is standardized and tradable, it's a future. Forwards are customizable. The correct answer is letter dog. The correct answer is letter dog. Very good, everyone. Now, let's proceed to options. Option is a contract that gives the holder the right to buy or sell an underlying asset at a specified price within a specified period of time. If you have an option, you are the holder of the option. You have the right to buy or sell an underlying asset. If it is a right to buy, it is a call option. If it is a right to sell, it is a put option. At a specified price, again, you have the right, huh? You have the right, but you have no obligation to materialize the transaction within a specified period of time. Okay? So I will give you 1 minute to answer this one. What is the fundamental difference between options and forwards? Fundamental difference between options and forwards. Okay, nasaan yung iba? Sige. Nasaan yung iba? What is a fundamental difference between options and forwards? Enter. Enter now. Enter. Okay. The seller of an option contract is obligated to perform. Okay? The writer, no? Or the seller of the option contract is obligated to perform, while the buyer of the option, that is the option holder, is not. Forward terms are typically binding to both the buyer and seller in the forward contract. Okay? The correct answer is letter A. Very good. Everyone. So lahat tayo sasagot, ha? So medyo magulo yung parties ng isang option. In a call option, this is the option to buy the underlying asset. In a put option, the holder has the right to sell the underlying asset. The words long and short does not pertain to the buyer or seller of the underlying asset. The words long and short does not pertain to the buyer or seller of the underlying, but rather, it pertains to the buyer or seller of the option. Take note of the difference. Diba last meeting, nag-discuss tayo, no? Nung last meeting, ano yung naalala nyo? Nung last meeting. Pagdating sa forwards or futures, long party, buyer ng underlying. Short party, seller ng underlying. Dito sa options, yung long party tsaka short party, hindi sila, no? Hindi sila yung buyer or seller ng underlying. Word long is the buyer, pertains to the buyer of the option. Short pertains to the seller of the option, not the underlying. For example, the long party is the buyer of the option to buy the underlying. Kasi call option to. The long party is the buyer of the option who has the right to sell the underlying. Being the buyer of the option, not necessarily of the underlying asset. It's the seller or writer of the option to buy the underlying. Okay? So, kailangan niya mag-sell kung i-exercise yung option to buy. The short party for a put option is the seller or writer of the option to sell the underlying. Kailangan niyang bilhin kung i-exercise yung option to sell ng long party. Okay? The point that I am making here is that the words long and short does not pertain to the buyer or seller of the underlying as it was in futures and forward contracts. But rather, it tells us who you are relative to the option. Kung ikaw ba yung buyer ng option, long party. Seller ng option, short party. Pag call option, you have the option to buy the underlying. Pag put option, you have the option to sell the underlying if you are the long party. If you are the short party, kung buyer yung long party, kailangan mong ibenta kung gusto niya. Kung seller yung long party, seller ng underlying, kailangan mong bilhin. Kasi yung short party ng options, ikaw yung nagsulat ng option. Ikaw yung nagbenta ng option. Malinaw? Sige. I hope that explanation was clear, ha? I hope that the explanation was clear. Okay. A proper way for a U.S. firm to hedge accounts payable denominated in pesos is through blank. A proper way for a U.S. firm to hedge accounts payable denominated in pesos is through blank. 30 seconds. Okay, enter. Everyone, please enter your answers. A proper way for a U.S. firm to hedge AP denominated in pesos is through blank. Okay. So if you want to hedge an accounts payable may kailangan kang bayaran in pesos. Again, US firm tayo, ha? Pag silent, kahit hindi binanggit, US firm tayo. We have a payable in pesos. So, anong gagawin mo? Kailangan mong bumili ng pesos. Tama ba? You need to buy a pesos. Okay? You need to buy an amount in pesos. So, what you have to do is letter A, buy a call option in pesos. Okay? Call option on pesos, no? Call option on pesos. The correct answer is letter A. Bakit ka magbebenta ng pesos? Kailangan mo nga magbayad in pesos. May payable ka in pesos, ha? You need to buy in pesos. Okay? You need to buy pesos to pay the AP. You need to buy the pesos in order to pay the AP. Kaso hindi mo pa kailangan ngayon. Paano kung tumaas yung presyo ng peso? Para ma-hedge yung transaction, hindi ka matatakot, bibili ka ng call options on pesos so that you have the right to buy the pesos when the time comes. Letter A. Okay ba? Next question. At the time an option expires, the value of the option is blank. Go. At the time an option expires, the value of the options is, okay, ha? At the last day na yan. It's the last day na. Game, enter. Ito na yung last day ng option, ha? This is the last day of the option. Everyone, please enter. Huling araw na ng option. Bukas, wala na. Bukas, hindi na magagamit yung option. At the time an option expires, no, the value of the option is basically the difference between the exercise price and the value of the underlying asset. Okay? Example, call option. You have the right to buy at 100. Yung stock price, 101. So, yung value ng option, 1 peso. Kasi nagbibigay siya sa'yo ng karapatan. Bilhin yun at 1 peso. No? Ignoring transaction cost. So, if you have the right to buy the stock at 100 pesos, pagkatapos 101 yung stock price, so, ano yung halaga ng karapatan mo? 1 peso. Yung pwede mong kitain. No? The willing buyer will pay 1 peso for that option. Tandaan, wala nang bukas. It will be exercised now. So, they are equivalent. No? Of course, after adjusting for transaction costs. We assume it to be immaterial naman pagdating sa text, no? Unless stated. Letter dog, ha? The difference between the exercise price, the value of the underlying asset. Take note as well that the option's value cannot be lower than 0. Hindi ka naman pinipilit mag-exercise. So kung hindi advantage sa'yo, wag mo lang i-exercise. The lowest possible value of an option is 0. Okay? Hindi pwede mag-negative. Next question. What is the payoff for a put option with a strike price of 22? If the price of the underlying stock at expiration is 19. We'll give you 1 minute to think about this. Mag-isip kayo ng mabuti, ha? Enter. Enter your answers, everyone. Enter your answers, everyone. Enter your answers, everyone. So you have the right to sell this stock for 22. Yung underlying stock, it is at $19 at expiration. May karapatan kang makabenta at 22. At expiration, $19, no? $19 yung underlying niya. Okay lang? Nakuha nyo? May karapatan kang ibenta siya ng 22, 19 lang yung halaga niya. You're given the additional right to sell it for $3 more. So if you're going to sell the option, it is around $3, no? The value of the option, put option to be specific, is $3 at this point. The correct answer is letter A. O kakasabi ko lang kanina, no? Anong sinabi ko kanina? The time an option expires, the value of the option is the difference between the exercise price and the value of the underlying asset. Kikita ka ba kapag i-exercise mo to? Oo, kikita ka ng 22 minus 19. $3. Kaka-explain ko lang, ha? Kaka-explain ko lang. Do you have any questions? If you have any questions, please raise them anytime. Next, what is the payoff for the owner of a call option with a strike price of 35 if the underlying stock price at expiration is $30? Okay, everyone, enter your answers. Lahat, ha? Titingnan ko kung naintindihan nyo. Enter your answers, everyone. Lahat, ha? Everyone. Everyone, 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 everyone. Okay. So, you have the right to buy the option. Call option to, ha? This is a call option. You have the right to buy it at 35. At expiration, it is 30. May karapatan kang bilhin yung $30 ng 35. Sinong tanga yung bibili ng 35 kung kaya naman yung bilhin ng 30? Nobody would like to exercise the option. Okay? Malulugi siya ng $5. At first glance, you might say, negative 5 yung sagot. Pero isipin niyo to. Kung nandiyan na kayo sa sitwasyon, bumili kayo ng option na ito yung strike price, hindi mo naman i-exercise to. But rather, you're just going to the open market. You're going to the open market. Pagkatapos, bilhin mo at $30. In other words, zero yung value ng option. Okay? Kakasabi ko lang kanina, ha? Hindi pwedeng mag-negative yung value ng option. Yun yung logic nun. No? Isipin nyo na lang, sino naman ang tanga? Kung kaya niyang bumili ng 30, bakit niya bibilhin ng 35? Diba? Huwag na lang niya i-exercise ang option. So the correct answer is zero. Hindi naman siya pinipilit i-exercise yung option. It's a right but not an obligation. The correct answer is dog. Okay, medyo marami-rami na yung nakatama, no? Yun yung logic nun, no? Isipin nyo na lang. Kung ako ba may hawak nito, i-exercise ko ba? If I am the long party, will I exercise this? If your answer is no, the answer is zero. Okay lang? Yan na lang, no? If the answer is yes, Kunin niyo yung difference. Sige. How about this one? How about this one? Consider a corn farmer who expects to produce 55,000 bushels of corn at the end of this season. To hedge the risk associated with corn prices, the farmer purchases put options to cover his entire crop. The put options have a strike price of 850 per bushel, a premium of 0.40 per bushel. He also sells an equal amount of call options with a strike price of 850 per bushel and a premium of 0.35 a bushel. Which of the following statements is correct? 1 minute. Okay, everyone, please answer. Okay, bumili siya ng put option. Okay ba? Enter your answers, everyone. Enter your answers, everyone. Okay, alin dyan yung tama? Okay, so ang tama dito, mabebenta niya yung corn for at least 850 a bushel. Okay? Wala siya makukuha immediately, no? Hindi naman to immediate yung gain or loss, no? Okay? So the farmer has guaranteed that he will sell his corn for 850 a bushel. Hindi na bababa dyan, no? Hindi na bababa dyan. The correct answer is letter dog. That is how options work. Ngayon, kapag tumaas yung market price ng corn, naging $9, pwede naman wag niyang gamitin yung option, no? Huwag niyang gamitin yung option at ibenta sa open market. Okay? Pero kung bumaba, eh, syempre gagamitin mo yan. No? Kasi seller ka. Gusto mong ibenta ng mas mataas. Sana nakukuha nyo ya yung principles ng option. What is the fundamental... Ay! Ano to? Tapos na to, no? Sorry for the repetition. Okay na to. Next question. Which of the following statements about option payoff is false? S, the stock price. X, the strike price. I'll give you 2 minutes to think about this. In the money, kikita ka. At the money, zero yung kita mo. Out of the money, negative kung i-exercise mo. Pero syempre, hindi mo i-exercise. So pag positive yung value, may value siya in the money. When you exercise now, no? Pag zero at the money, kapag negative kung i-exercise, it's called out of the money. We are looking for the false statement. I'll give you 2 minutes. Okay, thank you, Ellen Joy, for clarifying that. Meron palang defense ngayon. Okay. Thank you, Ellen Joy, ha? My bad, hindi ako nag-check ng email.
Shopee Express.
Okay, sorry ha. Ginage ko. Akala ko umaabsent na kayo. Okay. Okay lang yun, no? Nag-email naman pala. My bad. Okay, anyway, yung mga nandito, please answer this. Which of the following statements about option payoffs is false? Assume S is the stock price and X is the strike price. S is the stock price and X is the strike price. Enter. Enter your answers, everyone. Okay lang magkamali, no? Huwag niyong hintayin yung sagot ng iba. Okay. So, if the stock price and the strike price are the same, it is at the money. Tama ba? At the money yan. Kapag yung stock price tsaka yung strike price ay parehas, it is at the money. A and dog, mukhang tama naman sila, no? So, letter A and letter dog, ilipat mo si X sa kabila to the other sides of the equation. S is equal to X. The call option is at the money. If S is greater than X, the stock price is greater than the exercise price, what it means is that yung put option mo, masarap i-exercise. Ito lang yung exercise price, sabihin natin 10 pesos. Tapos yung totoong stock price niya is 11. Okay? Sorry, hindi pala masarap i-exercise. Ayaw mong i-exercise. This is out of the money, yung letter boy. Okay? Letter boy is out of the money. You can sell it for 10. The stock price is 11. You will not exercise the put option. Boy and C, the same lang to ha. S is greater than X if you would put X on the other sides of the equation. If it is a call option, mabibili mo siya ng mas mura, it is indeed in the money. Okay? In letter C, if S minus X is greater than 0, S is greater than X. Tama? If this is a call option, mabibili mo siya ng mas mababang presyo. No? Mas malaki yung stock price kaysa sa strike price. Kikita ka, it's in the money. Pero yung boy, put option ito, ibebenta mo ng mas mababang presyo kung i-exercise mo. This is out of the money. Very good. The correct answer is boy. Marami akong nakikitang tamang sagot. Next question. If the price of the underlying asset increases, what happens to the value of the call and put option? 1 million. Okay. Paki-inform na lang ha, yung mga nagdi-defense, good luck. Oo. Hindi ko kasi alam, no? Kasi hindi ako nagbabasa ng email. Sorry for that. Pag ganun, no? Sa GC na lang, pag marami kayo, no? Kung isa lang yung a-absent, okay lang PM. Tinatamad ako magbukas ng email, no? Okay. If the price of the underlying asset increases, what happens to the value of the call and the put options? Enter. Ano yung tumaas? Yung price ng underlying. Tumaas yung price ng underlying. Enter your answers now, everyone. Enter your answers. Game? Ah, sige. So, kung tumataas yung underlying asset, yung price niya, hindi na maganda yung put option. Yung call option, mas gumaganda. Mas gusto mong gamitin. The correct answer is letter boy. Okay, very good. Mukhang lahat nakaintindi dito. Sa mga sumagot, ha? Sa mga sumagot. Mukhang lahat nakaintindi. Okay, boy yung tamang sagot. If you have a put options, you do not want to exercise it anymore kasi tumaas yung presyo, no? E di, ibenta mo na lang as it is. Pero kung call option, bibilhin mo ng mas mababa, tumaas pa yung presyo, e may karapatan kang bumili ng mas mababa, mas gusto mong i-exercise yung call option. The correct answer is boy. Okay? Calculation of the gain or loss. Calculation of the gain or loss. That's next. Okay, game. Okay, sige, I'll give you 30 seconds more. I'll give you 30 seconds more. Okay, enter everyone. Enter everyone. Everyone, please. Please enter your answers. On January 15, an investor takes a long position. Bumili siya ng put option for 20 shares of a particular company for an option premium of $1 per share. The put option has an exercise price of 205, expires on March 31. The shares were trading at 202, January 15. But it dropped to 198 on March 31 when the put option was exercised. Okay, swerte, no? So, disregarding any option premium payments, so wag mo na munang isama yung option premium, ha? Ignore the option premium. How much did the investor gain or lose from the option transaction? Nabenta niya ng 205, okay? Bumagsak yung presyo ng 198. So, kumita siya ng 7. Tama? That's 20 shares. $7 times 20 shares is $140. Letter C, that's a gain of 140. So thank you for answering. Those who are answering consistently, tuloy nyo lang, ha? The correct answer is C, a gain of 140. dollars. Okay. How about this one? I'll give you 2 minutes. Game, everyone, please answer. PeachGen Inc. stock was trading last month at $22 per share. There were two types of options available on the stock. Call options with a strike price of $16, which expire at the end of the month, were trading at $6. Put option with a strike price of $16 expire at the end of the month, we're trading at $1.10. Larry invested $132 in common stock. Kitty invested $132 in the call options. Marek invested $132 in the put option. At the end of 1 month, the price of Pigeon Inc. is $25. How much money did Kitty make from the investment? So si Kitty nag-invest ng 132. If the value of one option is $6, 22 options yung nabili niya. By the way, enter your answers. Pakibigay mo na yung sagot natin. Okay na. Everyone, please enter your answers. Huwag kayong mahiya. The investment is $132. So kung $6 isa, 22 options niya. So the gain is 25 minus 16. That's 22 options. 9, no? 9 times 22 is 198. Investment niya 132. Kumita siya ng 66, no? The correct answer is letter boy. Okay? The correct answer is letter boy. Take note, ha? They were trading at $6, no? Yung call option. So, ang ginawa niya, bumili siya ng 132 worth. 132 divided by 6, 22 options. So, yung kita mo sa isa, tumas kasi ng 25, no? So, bilhin mo ng 16, pero yung worth niya 25 times 22 options. 198 minus 132 is 66. Letter boy. Okay lang, no? Medyo complicated yung calculation. It's okay. How do we value options? How do value options? We may value options by assuming a riskless hedge at the end of the period. So, anong gagawin ng isang investor under our assumptions, no? So, an investor buys a stock and then simultaneously, magbebenta siya ng call option on the stock. Okay? So, ang gagawin niya, magbebenta siya ng, bibili siya ng stock. tapos magbebenta siya ng call option sa stock. So, mabebenta ba niya yung stock? Okay, makikita nyo. Kapag bumaba yung presyo ng stock, no? Kapag bumaba yung presyo ng stock, mabebenta niya at a particular price. Okay? Kung masyadong tumaas, magkakaroon siya na, sorry. Let me phrase it this way. Ang gagawin niya, bibili siya ng stock, ibebenta niya yung call option ng stock. Malinaw yon? Ngayon, yung call option, mabebenta niya yan at a particular price called the option premium. Mabebenta niya yan at an option premium. Ang isisingil niya sa option premium in such a way na kikita pa rin siya. Kahit na bumagsak yung presyo ng stock sa dulo, okay? Kung bumagsak yung presyo ng stock, pabor sa kanya kasi yung buyer ng call option niya hindi exercise yung call option. Pero kung tumaas naman yung stock price, i-exercise niya yung call option. One more time, ha? The investor would buy a stock. Pagkabili niya ng stock, magbebenta siya ng call option para sa stock na yun. Dalawa ang possible scenario. Bumaba yung presyo ng stock. When the price of the stock will go down, dapat masaya siya dahil nakabenta siya ng call option na walang halaga. No? Siya yung seller ng call option. Eh? Siya yung nakabenta ng call option. So kung magkano man siningil niya sa pagbenta ng call option, yun na yung profit niya. Okay? Yun na yung profit niya. Bumagsak man yung stock price. Kung tumaas yung stock price, edi maganda pa rin kasi may willing na buyer ng stock. No? Someone is willing to buy the stock. So, yun yung assumption kapag gumagawa tayo ng valuation ng option. We call this a riskless hedge. So, meron akong video kung paano to ginagawa. Okay? Anyway, I will give you the link for the video later on. In the meantime, we're going to discuss the risk. We're going to discuss swaps. Okay? We're going to discuss swaps. A swap involves the exchange of interest and sometimes principal in one currency for the same in another currency. Swaps involve the exchange of interest and in some cases, even the principal in one currency for the same in another currency. So, say for example, we have here the Bank of Amuro and the Bank of Eureka. May dalawa tayong banko dito. The Bank of Amuro and the Bank of Eureka. So, the Bank of Amuro earns interest in dollars, pero si Bank of Eureka, on the other hand, earns interest in euros. The expenses of Bank Amuro is in euro, however, marami siyang utang sa European country. Si Bank of Eureka, yung expenses niya, naka-dollar. Nakuha nyo? So, Bank of Amuro has interest revenues primarily in dollars, but most expenses in euro, while Bank of Eureka earns euros, but spends in dollars. Now, here's the problem. When the dollar goes up and the euro goes down, masaya si Bank of Amuro. Laki ng kita niya, mababa expense niya. Pero si Bank of Eureka, posibleng mabankrupt kung masyadong malala ito. The euros may go down. Yung expenses naman niya, dollars, tataas. Revenues niya bababa, tataas expenses niya. Pwede siyang malugi. If the other scenario would happen, the dollar goes down and the euro goes up, what happens is the Bank of Amuro will be harmed. Bagsak revenue, taas expenses. Pero masaya naman si Bank of Eureka. Bababa yung kanya, tataas yung kanyang revenue, bababa yung kanyang expenses. So, if they would want to avoid the extreme sadness, they have to sacrifice the extreme happiness. Na? What they can do to manage the risk is for them to exchange their obligation. The Bank of Amuro will be the one to shoulder for the expenses of the Bank of Eureka, while Eureka will shoulder the expenses of Amuro. Para kung tumaas man yung euro, si Bank of Eureka, tumaas ang revenue, mataas din ang expense. Si Bank of Amuro, hindi maapektuhan negatively. Kung tumaas man yung dollar, kahit mataas yung expenses ni Eureka, si Bank of Amuro yung bahala. Okay? To prevent one from exposure to the highs and lows of the foreign exchange fluctuations, what they can do is to exchange their obligations. That is why we call it a swap. No? We call this a swap. No more exposure to the highs and the lows. This is not seen in the balance sheet. This is not seen in the balance sheet. Okay? Which of the following is not a financial instrument used to reduce the risk exposure associated with foreign currency exchange rates? We'll give you 40 seconds for this one. Ender, it is not a financial instrument used to reduce the risk exposure associated with foreign currency exchange rates. Alin dyan yung hindi? Ang hinahanap ko ang hindi ha, ang not, no? Not used. Very good. Walang currency stock. Currency stock does not exist ha. Walang ganito. We may use options, futures, may forwards pa nga, meron pang swap. Kaka-discuss ko lang yung swap, no? You may use it to reduce your exposure with forex fluctuations. Currency stock does not exist. Letter C. Next, which of the following financial instruments is a contract whereby organizations assume the foreign exchange risk of another party? Giving you 30 seconds for this one. Game. Enter everyone. Which of the following financial instruments is a contract whereby organizations assume the foreign exchange risk of another party? Especially banks, no? Usually yung mga banks gumagawa nito. Okay, as discussed, we call this a currency swap, no? We call this a currency swap. Okay lang? So next meeting, pupunta tayo ng corporate restructuring. What I want you to do for the remaining session, panoorin yung dalawang video. Medyo complicated yung lecture. Ulit-ulitin nyo na lang, no? Kung may question kayo, next meeting na lang. Okay lang? Pagkatapos, isubmit nyo na yung exercises. Submit the exercises. Okay. Thank you for listening, everyone. Okay, that would be our live session. Okay, bibigay na ako ng videos and then i-open ko na yung discussion board. Thank you.